you, then using BLAST and FASTA, two different programs I have given. Today let me discuss to you only with the BLAST program. So it is sequence alignment with insulin protein. We are going to see how it can be done. So first thing, I'll try to discuss to you about the various database centers that are available, which I have discussed to you already also. So one of the important database center is called as the NCBI, which is called as the National Center for Biotechnology Information. So this NCBI, and in the Google, you can just, if you know the URL or the website name, directly you can type it and you can retrieve the home page of the database center. In case if you don't have any resources of the website or the URL, directly in the search engine like Google, you or Google Chrome or Internet Explorer, like that you can type NCBI, directly it will guide you to the home page of the NCBI. And this is the home page of the NCBI site, which we have already seen. So this is the URL site now, or this is the website name of the NCBI, that is National Center for Biotechnology Information. So the, you can see that there are various points which are given here, like submit your manuscript into the NCBI, or you can download the data to your computer. You can learn what are the facilities or the, how to go about with the various tools which are provided in the NCBI site. You can develop, you can analyze and do even the research. So to your left hand side, there are many different features which are available in the NCBI site. So you want the genetics and the medicine, genes and its expression, proteins or literature. Many people deposit even their literature also, once when they are depositing their sequences of amino acids or the nucleotides and chemicals and the bioassay procedures. So all these relevant data are available here. Similarly, the other resources which can link you from NCBI to the other sites is also available to your right hand side. So here, this most important one, which is called as a BLAST, is what we are going to see now. So generally, students, I ask that you have to do the sequence alignment using BLAST only. So you have to go to the NCBI site, you open the home page, and then you're going to go for this BLAST. So I'll tell you the steps how to do that one. So NCBI is a National Center for Biotechnology Information, where people are depositing the nucleotide sequence as well as the amino acid sequence of various proteins or genes in this website. So this website is well known for the sequences of the genes or the genomes of an organism, of a cell, as well as the amino acid sequences of various proteins. Okay, now the second database center is called as EMBL, which is called as the European Molecular Biology Laboratory. And you know that it has got six different spectrum of molecular biology, six sites at Barcelona, Hamburg, and EMBL, Ixton, and Rome. So in different locations, they are having the site. So it is European Molecular Biology Laboratory. It's a powerhouse of biological expertise. So the moment you go to your search engine like Google and then type as EMBL, the site will be opened up, and this is what will be the home page of EMBL. So this is also a site located in Europe, European countries, and it is also having a lot amount of deposition of the nucleotide as well as the amino acid sequences. And there are a lot amount of features which are available with the EMBL, with which lot amount of work also can be done. So there are so many features under this EMBL also. This is the next database center, which is called as DDBJ, which is called as the DNA Data Bank of Japan. And this is the home page of this particular database center. So here also you have submission, where any of the data you have, you want to submit it, you can do it, you can download. then the details about the supercomputers which are present as a facility available, then statistics from the time inception of DDBJ till now, how they have developed, what are the list of various datas which are available with them, how they have improvised it, what is the collection they have, all such informations will be able to get it. And there are a lot of these database centers provides us with lot amount of trainings and the activities in the form of seminars, guest lectures, then workshops. So if you want to enroll it, you can go into these locations and you can try to understand what are the facilities which are available with them, and also search and doing the analysis by using this DDBJ. So the name itself says that it is DNA Data Bank of Japan, which main center located in the Japan. So here also you can find lot amount of the gene sequences as well as the amino acid sequences. Then the next site is called as a database UniProt. So just type in the search engine as UniProt, or if you are very thorough with the URL site name, you can just type it and get into the home page of the this UniProt also. So you also have here BLAST. You can use this site also to do the BLAST peptide search. You can go for the peptide search. Then you have retrieving of the sequences, and one of the important resource of UniProt is even the SwissProt, where they are manually annotated and reviewed. So the data which is deposited in the SwissProt, which contains good amount of amino acid sequence data, will give you a lot amount of details related to a protein also. Okay, so here also you have lot amount of informations available. So I am trying to give you the various database centers where you can log in to get your data or inputs. And this is a very good database center which is called as PDB, Protein Data Bank, where you will be able to retrieve the protein structure, my dear students. Earlier what I told you, mainly you will be able to retrieve only the nucleotide sequences, or you will be able to get the amino acid sequences. But PDB, Protein Data Bank, is mainly used for retrieving the structure of a protein molecule. So many people are using this database centers where there are a lot of informations which are available. So if you're thorough with the protein literature, you can also go through the site in order to understand. And many of the deposits, what the scientists do over here is that they will isolate the protein from a source, and that protein has to be obtained in a highly purified form. Once they get it in a highly purified form, they are going to go for either X-ray crystallography or NMR studies to get the structure of the protein molecule. And once they get the structure of the protein, then they can deposit in this PDB databank center. So when these people are checking out the quality of the protein structure which has been deposited, the resolution must be very good, and then only the acceptance will be done in the protein data bank. So a lot of literature is also available related to this, and you can go through this PDB database center also to get the three-dimensional structure of the proteins. Then these are the steps. Now I'm going to tell to you how to go about with the NCBI site and to perform the BLAST procedure. So you can note down the procedure. I will share with you this PPT also. You can please go through it and learn and practice it. I'll tell you what you're supposed to do later. So go to the Google site and just type NCBI if you are not familiar with the site name. So I've typed just NCBI. So this is step number one. Go to the search engine and type the URL or the search in the search engine, the site name. So I've typed NCBI. So once I type that one and put enter, this is what you will be getting the information. The first one itself, so many results. This is the first result which it is taking me directly to the location of the site, that is National Center for Biotechnology Information. And you can find the URL site which very clearly gives to you that this is a site what I am looking for it. So search for NCBI site, and this is the site URL, and you can just click on to this one and it will take you to the home page which I just now showed you. So this is the home page of the NCBI site, what you will be able to get it. So once you get into the NCBI site, now your process starts. Like, go to this place. You see on the top you are seeing a small bar over here where you have to click. Earlier it was here, you see, when I put the mark here, you can see it is written as all databases and arrow mark over here facing downwards. Click that arrow mark, a scroll bar, just scrolling will happen. From that scroll bar, there will be lot amount of informations available, but my target is to do for the protein sequence alignment. So you just select over here protein, and I am interested to do it on the insulin. So you see here in the first picture, you are able to see all databases, and in the search block, it was empty over here, is it not? So once I selected here the protein over here, I am going to type the name of the protein which I am interested in. Today I am interested in insulin, so I've just typed over here as insulin. After typing insulin, go and click on the word over here which is given as search. So when you click the word search, it will go and take you to a next open page which will take few seconds for it to open up, and this is what it will be showing you, the result about all the different available proteins that are deposited in the NCBI site. So if you keenly observe here, out of so much of result, 1 to 20 will be given in the first sheet. Then if you want to search further, then go to the next sheet, you will get remaining other inputs available on the insulin. So here number 1 is given, children, and is given in blue color. You see insulin precursor. My target is to search for insulin only. The data which is available on this page will be many in number, so you are supposed to search and select only the insulin protein over here and not get diverted selecting any other features over here. Okay, and you have your accession number also. That is another one resource where you can copy it and paste it, and you can use it even for your BLAST process also. But I'll tell you how to do the other way also. So now I've seen here insulin precursor. I don't want this one. I want insulin protein alone. So what I do is that I scroll down in this page. You just further scroll down, and one place you'll be able to see as insulin, and it will be given the genus and the species name from where the data is, and I have taken here as insulin homo sapiens. So the specific data what you are going to take from these database centers is very, very important. You cannot just as your wish take it as insulin precursors or insulin growth factors, insulin mRNA. Lot of inputs will be there. See, the result says 11112519. So much of insulin deposits are there. So much of things are there, but you want from that only the insulin protein from the homo sapiens. So search for the result out of this and get only the insulin homo sapiens. Now what you do is that once you find that insulin homo sapiens label, you click on that one. You see one blue color box will be there and the name will be given which will be blue in color. Click only on that blue in color. Anywhere else you click, it will take you to somewhere else. So better you make a proper choice that you're going to click it only on the name of the protein with the where it has been studied from. So I want to take homo sapiens, so I just click it. The moment you click that one, a fresh page will open up within few minutes indicating to you that it is insulin and it is the homo sapiens, and there will be lot amount of informations which will be available related to that insulin protein which has been deposited by the authors. So once you have got that one point, now remember that in your computer you are supposed to open a Word document. So I have created a Word document, and in that Word, see here you can see Word document I have opened up. In that Word document, on the top, put the name, your roll number and date. This is the format how you are supposed to give the information question to me later when I'm asking you. After that, down, put the title as sequence alignment of proteins using BLAST. And now what is the first protein I've taken it as? Write that name of protein, insulin, and the species and the genus name from where we have taken, that is Homo sapiens. Okay, now as you go to that page and you get down, you'll be able to get the amino acid sequence. Copy that amino acid sequence and paste it in your Word document, because I have to check your answers only from the Word document and nowhere else. So you are supposed to create this Word document on your desktop, on your system, and you're supposed to paste it like this. This is the first step you have completed. You have retrieved, you have taken up the amino acid sequence of the insulin protein from the Homo sapiens. Now again, go back to your NCBI site and go for the next insulin protein only I've taken. I have not compared it with any other protein. I have compared insulin protein with insulin protein only, but the only change what I have made is the genus and the species name. So in first one, I took it as Homo sapiens, insulin only. Now I'm taking it as SUS scrofa. So SUS scrofa is another species from where I've taken the amino acid sequence. So go to that NCBI site, take the insulin and another species you take it, and as that page opens up, go down to the page and the last page you'll be able to find the amino acid sequence. So it starts from 1, goes till 60 amino acids will be there, then 61 to the remaining of it. So you have to copy it and you're going to paste it in your Word document. Are you able to see, children? So on the top, the first one, insulin, Homo sapiens, I have copy pasted it. Below insulin, the second one I've taken, I've copy pasted it. Now when you're copy pasting it, there'll be lot amount of data which will be coming over here in the Word document. So please make sure that any numbers, some slashes and all will be there. See that you are removing that and you are retaining only the amino acid sequence. So what you have done till now is that you have retrieved the amino acid sequence of insulin protein from two different organisms. So first step is done. Once it is done, now again you go back to your NCBI site. After going to the NCBI site, as I told you, on to the right side you'll be having the program which is called as the BLAST. Just you click on that BLAST program. The moment you click on that one, the BLAST program site opens up, and this is how the page will be. It will show you the four different blasting procedures what can be done, and BLAST expansion is called as basic local alignment search tool. This is mainly used to find regions of similarity between biological sequences. The program can compare nucleotide or protein sequences to sequence databases and calculate the statistical significance of the compared data. So what are the different types of BLASTs available? You have nucleotide BLAST, comparing a nucleotide with a nucleotide sequence. Then protein BLAST, comparing the protein with that of a protein BLAST, protein data. So like that you have it. Now our target is to do only the protein BLAST, because both the sequences you have taken is only an amino acid sequence of a protein molecule. So we are going to do only with the protein BLAST. So once this page opens up, just you click on this page, protein BLAST. The moment you click it, it will open a fresh window to you, showing you the page of the BLAST. Now this is the place where you people have to keenly observe what you are supposed to do, children. So what you see in the BLAST page is that the first there will be a small box in front of you, and this is the place where you are going to enter your query sequence. Sequence where you want to check whether it's similar or not, you want to check the query sequence. You can copy your, where did you paste your amino acid sequence? You have created a Word document, you have created the amino acid sequence, you have taken and you have saved it, is it not? So from that one, first one, whatever you have taken, that let we assume to be our query sequence. So copy only the amino acid sequence and paste it here. Once it is done, just as you see down, here you are able to see a word which is called as align two or more sequences. So the moment you click this box, this don't click the word, click the box, it will open one more new box below. Like this it will be. You see here, I have clicked that one. You see it is showing you the tick mark over here. So once I click that one, another box will open up similar to that of the upper box. But you see what is given here. Here it is given as enter subject sequence. Here it is given as enter the query sequence. Here it is asking you to submit your subject sequence. So you can give the amino acid sequence or you can also give the accession number, which I told you that for each and every protein which has been deposited will be having an accession number. So you can give that one also. Since I have asked you to copy and paste the amino acid sequence, let us do that one only. So you can see here what I have done. So the insulin protein amino acid sequence, I copied it from the Homo sapiens and I have pasted here. When I'm pasting it, make sure that there are no any dots, there are no any inverted commas, there are no numbers, only amino acid single letter words must be there. Similarly, the second one you have deposited, you have saved, insulin scrofata, is it not? So that one you copy it and paste it. Once you have done with two copy and pasting it, now below that one you can see the first blocks filled with the amino acid sequence, second one filled with the next sequence. Remember, first one is a query sequence, next one is a subject sequence. So down this program you will be able to see the word which is called as the BLAST. So you just click on the word BLAST. Just wait for a few seconds and the results will be displayed. So this is how the result will be. So the result page of the BLAST will be always like this only. Earlier we had another format. Now they have changed the format. So that is the beauty of bioinformatics. It's never stagnant. It's all a computer programs. According to the development of the technology, the programs also will be continuously changing and we have to update ourselves regularly. So you can see the details will be given. That is a job title. What we gave to the BLAST is to compare the protein sequence, and it will be giving you the expiry date, everything, and the program which was being done is BLAST. Only two sequences I have given, so it will show you only two sequences and the amino acids what it is, and the query length also it has considered over here. Now once you get this result on this page, as you just go below this page, you will be able to see a word called as description, and under description there will be three different words given which you have to now do the original process of your sequence alignment. One will be the graphic summary, the other one will be the alignment, the other one will be the dot plot. So your result has to be displayed in three different ways. One is a graphic summary, the other one is the alignment, the other one is a dot plot. So once you come to this page, down you will not find any information, children. So what you do is that first result must be graphic summary. So just you click on that graphic summary, it will show you the result. So this is the result of the graphic summary. So you are able to see the BLAST hit result. We call it as BLAST hit result. You have given two sequences to be compared. So the database has compared the two sequences and it has shown you whether how much similarity is there between both the sequences. So on the top you can see the alignment scores given over here. So each one color indicates the significance of the similarity or dissimilarity. Now if you get this line, only one single line you have got, children, the reason is because we have taken only two sequences for comparison. So the job done is only between those two sequences, and then only one single line will be the graphic summary. What what will be given. If you are comparing with two or three or multiple sequences, then you will get many number of colored lines one below the other. But since I have compared only two sequences, you have to get only one single line over here. And the line color, you see, it is pink in color. It is not red in color. That shows you that the similarity between both the sequences is between only 80 to 200. And if this line is in blue color or in black color, then you can understand that there is no any good similarity between both the sequences when they are compared. So this is the first result what you have got, which is called as the graphic summary. So the BLAST result will be studied or understood in three different formats. One is the graphic summary, the other one is the alignment, the other one is a dot plot. So I've shown you the graphic summary. Once you have finished that one, take the screenshot and paste it in your Word document. Okay. Now, next result, how to get it. After graphic summary is over, click on this word, which is called as the alignment. If you click it and select it, it will turn the color. The color gets changed to blue color. Now you see, this is the original one, alignment, what has been happened. So listen properly what has happened over here. First sequence, what you gave is called as a query sequence. Then you given the subject sequence, children. So the query sequence, if you see, the first amino acid is M, which is called as methionine. And the subject sequence, what we have in given also is M. So methionine, methionine. So it has compared both and found that it is similar. So it has written in the center as M. The alignment first one is over. Now come to the second amino acid. In the query, it is alanine. In the subject also, it is alanine. Both are same, so it has written alanine. Even L, even W. W is tryptophan. Now come to the fifth amino acid. Do you find a gap over here? Why did the gap come over here? On the top, you're finding M, which is methionine, and down you're finding T, which is threonine. It's not tyrosine, it is threonine. And methionine is a sulfur group containing amino acid. Threonine is a hydroxyl group containing amino acid. Both of them are not similar. They both are different. So when the system has compared, when the database has compared query and the subject, it found that there is no any similarity. So it has given a gap. That is a one gap what you are able to observe it. Now as you move, you can just check out everywhere, it will be the same only. Once it is same, the center will be written. If it is different, it will leave a space. Now here you can find G glycine, you find here A alanine, different, a gap is there. P and P proline, it has written. D and A, different amino acid, a gap is there. So as you check out, there will be lot amount of gaps present over here. Now, something very interesting you can find in this particular sequence, that on the query sequence it is D, on the subject sequence it is N, and it is given as positive. That means what? It says that both the amino acids are acidic amino acids. It is going to be glutamic acid and the aspartic acid must be the amino acid. So it is giving us a clue that they are going to be acidic amino acid. They are not similar, but still they are going to be the similar amino acids, similar type of the amino acids, which are going to be the acidic amino acids. So it has taken a positive sign over here. Okay, so now you can find that there is a good comparison, and wherever there is no comparison, there is a difference, there will be the gaps present. So by just seeing these two sequences only, you can understand that there are a lot amount of gaps between both the sequences. That gap was a reason for us to give the BLAST hit summary, that is a graphic summary, also pink in color. If there is a very good similarity between the sequences, then that line would have been red in color. But in the graphic summary, you got a pink color. That shows the similarity is close to that of only 80 to 200. So this is what is the sequence alignment, comparing the query sequence and the subject sequence, has been done, and the result has been displayed over here. Got it? Coming to the third result, which is called as the dot plot. So first is the graphic summary, next is the alignment, next is the dot plot. So you just click it, you will be able to get a graph over here. So what the system has done is that this is a dot plot. What it will do is that it follows a very systematic procedure of checking the amino acids query with the subject, and if it is similar, it will put a dot. If there is a dissimilar, the dot will not be there. So by joining all those number of dots, you will be getting a line, and you are able to see a break over here. So that is because of that non-similarity between the bases. So these are the three results what you will get. So all the results what you have to, whatever you have got it, you are supposed to copy and paste it in your Word document. See, the complete Word document, I have kept the screenshot for you. So sequence alignment of protein using BLAST, insulin protein, amino acid sequence, first you should keep. Then result must be the heading, graphic summary, put the screenshot of it. Second one, alignment summary result, screenshot. Third one, dot plot result, you have to copy and paste it in your Word document, and you're going to submit it to me as the experimental result. So that these are all the steps how we are going to perform of a protein molecule.